Hey everyone, welcome back to Chip Stock Investor. Happy 2026. Just me today. Casey's working on some other projects, but you can see her in our last video. If you haven't caught it yet, we did a review of our top picks all the way back from 2024 all the way through the end of 2025. You can see how we did. And as we get started here in 2026, our top holding here at Chip Stock Investor is, of course, Nvidia. That remains our top pick for this year as well, not coincidentally. And so let's jump into it. It's a new year. Nvidia's Jensen Huang is at CES in Las Vegas, where he mentioned this little tidbit.
Now, every single chip that we were describing just now can be a press conference in all in itself. And there's an entire company who's probably dedicated to doing that back in the old days.
It is not the old days. Even here at Chipstock Investor, we are not going to do a breakdown of all six new chips NVIDIA talked about with the release of the Vera Rubin and the scale-up of manufacturing of Vera Rubin that Jensen was talking about here in this video. Why is that the case? Well, in this era of AI, it's not about individual chip innovation anymore. It's about that full-stack compute innovation that NVIDIA likes to talk about. Everything from chip design to system level design to the actual infrastructure and build of the software itself and all points in between. This is why we built the Chipstock Investor web app, where you can get access to, of course, all of our research and updates on our portfolio, as well as stocks we are buying and occasionally ones that we might be selling. And most importantly, the why behind those portfolio updates. And we designed the layout of all of this to help you get an understanding of that full stack compute and the supply chain, especially the manufacturing supply chain and software development. It's big, it's complex, and it's a difficult patchwork that investors need to navigate to figure out where to allocate their money. Beyond that, you can even drill down and get specific company information, including some financial data tables. We've partnered with our friends over at fiscal.ai on this with some basic charting functions. Check it out, the Chipstock Investor Research Platform. Link here on the video or in the description below. Now, about those six new chips specifically that NVIDIA announced, of course, we have the two chips where the name came from, Vera Rubin. Vera being NVIDIA's CPU paired with the Rubin GPU, specifically two Rubin GPUs per system that help with an up to 5x increase over and above Blackwell for AI inference. Beyond those two flagship chips, we also got a peek at the ConnectX 9 Spectrum X SuperNIC, as well as the Bluefield-4 DPU. We're going to come back to those two specifically here in just a moment. But finally, rounding out the six, we have the NVLink 6 switch and the Spectrum X Ethernet CPO, or co-packaged optics. Check out our latest video on the state of the AI data center networking industry. We'll also have that linked here and in the description of the video as well. But let's get back to this. SuperNIC and Bluefield-4 DPU, or data processing unit, which is actually a Grace CPU with that ConnectX 9 you can see pictured above the DPU itself. What is this latest generation of the Bluefield-4 specifically? It is a storage processor. And in tandem with the Vera Rubin update, NVIDIA also talked about this at CES. It's inference context memory storage platform powered by this new DPU, the latest generation, Bluefield-4. Now, why is this important? The AI infrastructure part of the IT industry is gradually evolving from AI training, including hyperscaler backend processes, to AI inference. That's when the AI is done training, it gets deployed into software, and users start interacting with it. It could be via an AI chatbot like OpenAI's ChatGPT, or it could be some other open model that is used within a piece of software that you've already been using all along, and maybe it now has some AI features or an AI agent that helps boost your productivity within that application. But AI training is a very different problem than AI inference. And so there is this worry and constant talk that a lot of other companies, AMD, Broadcom and its work with Google on the TPUs, tensor processing units, Intel, are catching up with NVIDIA on this front. But NVIDIA is still very much leading in innovation. And there have been a number of acquihires as of late that are already leading to some early new products. For example, just a few months ago, we had on our public blog on shipstockinvestor.com an article about NVIDIA's acquihire of a startup called Enfabrica and the system itself called Emphasis, or Elastic AI Memory Fabric System for AI Inference Offload. Kind of sounds like some of this acquihire and the licensing that NVIDIA did from Enfabrica went into some of this work that was just announced with the Bluefield-4 DPU and the Inference Context Memory Storage platform. But let's get into it a little bit, because the problem here is to make AI inference efficient, a different architecture is needed that holds more memory in cache that can be accessed by these GPU compute nodes. We grabbed this press release here from NVIDIA partner IBM. They also had an announcement in tandem with this at CES, where they are working within this new NVIDIA architecture for inference data storage, effectively increasing the KV cache. That is the data that is held in a type of intermediate storage that the GPUs need to access frequently while they're doing AI inference. And using that Bluefield-4 DPU storage processor, NVIDIA and partners can basically extend and increase the data capacity of that KV cache. And in this case, it's not using DRAM, like what's talked about from Emphasis, but instead, it looks like non-volatile memory, or NAND flash, which unfortunately also just so happens to be in short supply in 2026, just like DRAM and HBM and pretty much everything else in memory chips these days. But what's going on here is NVIDIA knows it needs to continuously increase the token generation potential of its systems for its customers and make that token generation very efficient so that ongoing operating costs can continuously be reduced. And that in turn increases the adoption of AI-powered software. And Bluefield-4 is essentially acting as the chip that governs the software architecture for AI inference. This is called NVIDIA Dynamo. And here's a diagram from NVIDIA showing how Dynamo works, how it coordinates the movement of data and serves up these AI tokens for AI inference when users interact with the software. And you can see there on the right-hand side, the KV cache manager and data offload interacting with, in this case, in context of what we're talking about here with the announcement at CES, NAND flash storage, which is a high data capacity storage solution. And so in tandem with Vera Rubin, we have this Bluefield-4 powered system that helps coordinate all of that data caching that can be used by the Vera Rubin systems specifically for AI inference workloads. Altogether, a very different problem than AI training, which Vera Rubin can also be used for. But the big breakthrough here, the up to 5x increase in AI inference when using Vera Rubin. So NVIDIA very much still in pole position here in innovating and pushing AI data center infrastructure forward in 2026 with the slew of new announcements. We expect we're going to hear more about these at NVIDIA GTC in March, just a few more months from now. And so what is our baseline assumption for NVIDIA stock in 2026? Let's recap. We actually have this put together for our semiconductor insiders and users of the ChipStock Investor Research Platform back in November and December, in the midst of that last downturn. And our base case for 2026 remains the same. As of the Q3 update for NVIDIA, earnings per share and free cash flow per share are up only 37%, only in parentheses, up 37% and 29% respectively, compared to the end of fiscal 2025. The period ended in January 2025. And over that period of time, the stock price is up less than, at this point, just under 30% over the last trailing 12-month period. So our assumption here is, given Vera Rubin is now scaling up Blackwell sales, reaching some sort of peak, until Vera Rubin reaches full capacity, our full expectation is that per share profitability is probably going to increase 50% plus over this next year. But we think that the slower growth rate for the stock itself, let's say 20% to 40% in that range, would be healthy to allow for some future slowdown or even a cycle down in AI infrastructure build out. NVIDIA stock does already trade for about 25 to 30x 1 year forward expected earnings per share and free cash flow per share. And so we think the stock price rising less than per share profit growth would be healthy given that 1 year forward premium on the valuation to account for some just good old fashioned infrastructure cyclicality. Currently, we're in the midst of a growth cycle for AI data center infrastructure. Some want to call that a bubble. If you want to call it that, that's fine. Really, what's happening is just we are in the midst of a growth cycle, and eventually we will have a cycle slowdown and a bit of a downturn. So that's what we're looking at for NVIDIA this year. Per usual, we're tempering our optimism and being cautious given the cyclicality of the semiconductor industry. But there you have it, our personal top pick for 2026. Join us over at ChipStock Investor Semiconductor Insider, link in the description below, to get a full view of the entire IT and electronics supply chain from chip design all the way to ultimate software, and then rinsing and repeating. Virtuous cycle of continuous improvement. We talk about it all over there. We have live weekly events. Look forward to seeing you over there. Take care, everybody. See you again later this week. Thank you.